when you're on the radio, you develop a relationship with your fans that becomes family-like. You really do feel like family. It's a very intimate thing, and I cherish it. I love it. When fans come up to you, it's different than when they know you from TV or movies. They're really like, hey, like, we spend a lot of time with you. And it becomes a family thing, and I really appreciate that. I do, not to get too sentimental, but I really appreciate when people come up and say, hey, we miss hearing you here, we love hearing you there, you know, are you doing okay? We heard you had some problems. They listen to your life's odyssey, and it's great. So to all the fans that might be listening tonight, I have a very big personal announcement that I got to tell you is something a lot of people would think would probably never happen with me. I'm trying to mature as much as I can. And I took a big step in that way. And as you know, my girlfriend, Adrian, I've been dating on and off for 4 years, over 4 years. She is a doll. She's beautiful. 29 years old. She's gorgeous. She's a beautiful inside as out. She's just unbelievably wonderful. A great heart. She takes care of me. And I love her to death. And to all my family out there and my friends and fans, during the vacation, I shared with her that I have herpes, and she's fine with
it. She's not going anywhere.
No. At the beginning of the vacation, I asked her to marry me, and she said yes.
Hot damn. Here we go. Congratulations, buddy. That's all right.
I am engaged.
Nice. You look different.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do. You look much more mature.
Well,
my
wallet's a little lighter.
Not yet.
And you broke John Ritchie's heart, and that's why he's not here.
Nobody's getting married out there. Everybody's grub. No, she said yes. I cannot.
Good for you, man.
Yeah, no, I am very, I'm 45. She's 29. And again, people always say, what do you have in common? And I always say that, the year she was born was the year I got my first DUI, and it's very intimate.
Excellent.
But she's just a wonderful person. She's such a doll, comes from a great, great family, good people, and I don't know. I'm very sentimental about it. I'm very happy, and I think it comes at a great time in my life where I'm getting the groove with my own show here at DirecTV, and the DirecTV family has made me feel wonderful, and the people that work here. But most of all, I really wanted to share this with the radio audience, my fans that have known me now for over a decade and are really cool. And I felt like I had to announce that to them. And my family, my mom and sister and everybody took us out to a big engagement dinner last night at the Jersey Shore, a place called Ama in Seabright, which, by the way, Italian joint, I highly recommend. And there's this little motel that I used to go to as a kid with my family from the ages of 2 to 14.
In Seabright?
The Crusader Motel is in Wildwood, New Jersey. And the last 2 weeks of every year, of every August, my father would stop climbing roofs for a living, and he would get the van, and we'd go down the last 2 weeks and stay in room 301. He always called a year ahead to get room 301 in this little motel. And it was on the water, and we were there from the age, when I was 2 to 13. So 11 full years, and the years like 68 to 81, those 13 summers. And out of nowhere, we were supposed to meet, and Adrian said, why don't we meet in Wildwood to have some lunch? I hadn't seen her in a while. So I said, this is an omen. We went to the motel, and I asked her to come up by room 301. You can still walk right up there.
Wow.
And we get to room 301, and there's people around. And I get, and some of them recognize me. I get down on one knee, which, by the way, took an hour. I did it as traditional as by in front of room 301. I got down on one knee, and she couldn't believe it. She was like, what are you doing?
Oh, that's cool.
I think she thought I was having a heart attack. And then I said, Adrian, I love you. And I always pictured doing this. I can't believe I'm doing it, but I can't imagine being with someone better. And will you marry me? And she threw up and said yes. She said yes. She said yes right away.
Great.
And that's awesome. And it did. It actually took me. I needed her help to get off the knee. And a couple of people recognized me, were looking at me. One guy gave me like a half thumbs up. But I'm engaged.
Congratulations.
Girls, what do you think of that?
I think it's fantastic. You told me earlier and I screamed so loud.
I know. I was looking at you and Bocchetti. I said, I got to tell one other person. I told Falada.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was like you had a heart attack.
No, I was in the other room and I hear him screaming, and I was like, what's going on now? Well, yes. I think it's great. I think it's so great.
Did you catch her off guard? Because it sounds like you caught her off guard, right?
No, that was the thing. We've been discussing it, and the thing, I wasn't dumb enough to get the ring on my own because I've been through this with, like, buying women purses and stuff. You always buy the wrong thing. So we got a little, like, $2 thing.
A substitute for a little while, right.
Right, so we're looking at a ring. And
smart. At least that way she'll get what she wants.
Right. We're going to have one by the end of the week. I think we're going to settle on one. And so it was. She was completely off guard, nice. Which was great.
Heck yeah.
But you girls are happy, right? You like it?
I love Adrian. I think it's great. Yeah. It's good for you. It's a happy way to start.
It is. It is. I need this. I need her. Yeah. And
now you have to lose weight for the wedding.
You're right.
I know.
I already believe me. I've been getting that for the last 2 weeks like crazy.
I'm sure.
But Shetty, what are your thoughts on this?
I'm super excited for Audie. This is going to be great for you. Women rule, and you need a great woman in your life.
Women rule. Well, I mean, you shouldn't say that in general. I mean, there could be. I mean, you got to calm down over there.
Okay.
But no, I appreciate
good
your
women
enthusiasm.
Rule.
Right now, you, can you tell I'm happy?
Yeah.
Because it's hard with me.
No, but
I really am very happy.
If you can tell when you came in.
Yeah,
you were different when you walked in.
I don't know. Thank you.
You are. You were a little different. A little peppier.
I really am happy. It's very hard to get me happy. You know, I usually need drugs. But I don't know. I feel really good about this. And she's such a doll. I just love. Dan's known her longest out of anybody here. And she likes Dan. Dan and her have a good relationship. Right?
Oh, I love her.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. What are you laughing at?
Just Dan. What? He's saying, you know, just because he's like, I don't know. He's just funny.
Well,
I didn't say I didn't know. I said I love
it's
her.
It's in the candy.
But
it sounds like Joe Pesci, like, well, like, what, like, you know, the way I talk. Well,
no, because he always gets made fun of for being creepy, so it's just funny, you know.
He does.
Dan Filato.
What?
Anyway.
You make fun of him all the time for that.
Well, on the air, we're goofing around.
I don't know.
I like the guy. I'm considering him for my best man.
You couldn't have made a better choice. Jesus.
Congratulations, buddy.
No, I'm not. Actually, Dan might be in the wedding, though. Might be in the wedding, Dan. But I have someone in mind for my best man, and I haven't asked him yet. I wonder if I should do it on the air. He might be listening.
Is that putting him on the spot, you think? Or
no, he'll do it for sure. But I'll say it on the air. You know, this will be fun. Maybe he's listening.
Handsy?
Liberace. Maybe he's listening. And this might be okay because I have a lot of great close friends I went to high school with, a lot of buddies of mine who I'm really close with.
Sure.
And it could be any one of them. It could be people I've worked with in my life, a lot of comics who I'm very close with. But I thought about this, and I'm going to ask someone who, since my father died, has been like an older brother and a father figure to me, and a guy who I just love, and is my godfather, actually. I'm going to ask my Uncle Tommy.
Nice.
My Uncle Tommy or Dan. Yeah. I haven't asked him officially yet, but I'm going to ask my Uncle Tommy to be my best man. So hopefully he'll say yes. I'm sure he will. Maybe he'll help you listen to Uncle Tom. If not, I'll... It's funny, Hansy knows before him. All right, so that's that. I appreciate you guys letting me get a little personal stuff off my chest.
Congratulations, buddy.
Yay. I'm engaged to Adrian. I love her. And sometime in the next 18 years, we'll be married. next summer, maybe.